welcome to the night section. So I know most of you guys have heard about the Saweetie situation, her performing live at the Triller Fight Club, and it just not being good. And honestly, there's many layers to this. For one is the fact that it really shows you that actual talent is not based on how many followers you have, and that two, live performance is an art in itself. However, I know Saweetie has worked very hard to get herself in a position that she is in today, and there's no taking that away from her. I know in the past, it's been a common theme that she struggled with the live performance side of things, including a couple years ago, where she actually freestyled for the Hot 97 squad, aka Peter Rosenberg, Ebro, and Laura Styles, and again, it just wasn't the best. Here's a clip.
Bae lace me with a watch. The diamonds, they be dancing. I could better see the clock. Tick tock, whoa. That mean your girl real icy. That means I don't got times for girls that don't like me. I be minding my own biz, but they check up on me like a parent does they kid. How does that really feel? You don't
Earlier
know
this year, in an interview with Cosmopolitan magazine in April, she says, quote, "It was a really dark point in my life. I went from being so loved so quickly because of Icy Girl to on my first promo run. Well, you saw the interview. The script flipped really quick, like night and day. I was like, wait, I had PTSD from that." End quote. So clearly she was made aware by the Hot 97 team, as well as the public, that it wasn't good. And yes, they gave her some constructive criticism. Obviously, when she says it gave her PTSD, from what I assume, she's probably referring to the public reception, which completely flipped as her song Icy Girl was a hit and everyone loved her for it. Now, all of a sudden, she's under scrutiny. And well, let's be honest, the public and keyboard warriors are very unforgiving. Now, of course, in the same month of April, we know the video of her performing live at the Triller Fight Club was circulating around. And well, I personally saw it, and for the 100th time at this point, I apologize if I keep repeating myself, but it wasn't good. If you saw it, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Everything from the dancing that she was doing, she seemed very out of her element, as if she was trying to remember her steps while trying to recite her lyrics in sync with the backing track. There were many moments where you can see her mouth the lyrics and it was completely out of sync, which completely defeats the purpose and the idea of lip syncing, because you would think it would have made it easier for her to do the choreography. To put it simply, not everyone is able to do Beyonce or Michael Jackson numbers. Those are clearly anomalies. She would have just been fine rapping and pacing back and forth, and maybe do like a two-step and shuffle in the choruses. But this brings us to a bigger conversation, because with artists now being able to get big online without ever needing to leave their house, a lot of the art and performance has been lost. And I don't blame Saweetie at all, and I'm glad she recognizes that she has a lot of stuff to work on. Like in her recent interview with Apple Music, she said that she is going through an artist development bootcamp to improve in the areas she's lacking.
So now I'm interested. What takes place in this artist development bootcamp? What happens?
Well, for me, I'm gonna focus on what I struggle with. I struggle with breathing control. I'm gonna work on my dance move, my details, all that good stuff. My just body, my stamina, my everything.
As you hear mentioned in the clip, she said she was going to the boot camp to work on things like her breath control, dance moves, etc. And I think a lot of people in general underestimate what it actually takes to put on a great show. And unless you're like Saweetie and actively performing, you don't really know as an artist what you need to work on. Artists like Beyonce and Michael Jackson, as an example, really rose to prominence at a time where you needed to be an entertainer in order to be considered a true artist. It wasn't enough to just be a recording artist. In order to sell out shows and have people want to come to see you prior to the 2010s, you had to be the full package. Sing good, dance good, but more importantly, be able to do those two things at the same time. Some of the more younger-ish artists that stand out to me that still place value in performance and are actually amazing at it are artists like Chris Brown, who's obviously been in the game for a while now, but a more recent artist that stands out to me and that has rose to prominence in the last 5 years is Doja Cat. And when I say performance, I mean singing while dancing, putting on a great show. Now, I understand that not everyone is gifted with being able to dance, but it's definitely something you can learn, and I guess that's what really separates artists from true entertainers. And like with anything else, to entertain takes work. I remember hearing that Beyonce, when her father Matthew was her manager, as well as managing Destiny's Child, he would make all of the girls basically run miles every day while singing. And I mean every day, 7 days a week. So that when it was time to perform and do those big dance numbers, they would be able to sing and dance seamlessly. This would overall build their stamina. And this just goes to show that this was a time there was actual integrity in singing live. And no wonder Beyoncé vocally is just a powerhouse because of all of that work that was being put in and day out. So imagine in contrast, people that are lip syncing and getting out of breath. It's not even comparable, honestly. The art of being a live performer and being great at that, just like anything else, requires practice. If you're a vocalist of any kind, it requires breath control, whether you're dancing or not, because you should be moving constantly across the stage, engaging with your audience. And if you've ever performed at any level, you understand that it's very easy to get out of breath performing a song, even if you're not doing backflips. You also need to be able to maintain eye contact and not be staring at the floor. You need to know your lyrics like the back of your hand, so you're not overthinking on what to sing or rap next. You also need to be confident. That energy feeds into the crowd, believe it or not, especially if you're an unknown artist and trying to win the crowd over. Now that's all from me, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please be sure to subscribe and engage about anything you like throughout this video as well. Please leave a like, it really does help, and hit the bell notification if you do want to see more. Night Section 2.